The longest day of the year in Juneau, Alaska is June 21st. It's 1,096.5 minutes long. Half a year later, when the days are at their shortest, the days are about 382.5 minutes long. If it's not a leap year, the year is 365 days long, and June 21st is the 172nd day of the year. Write a trigonometric function that models the length L of the tth day of the year. So it's going to be L as a function of T, assuming it's not a leap year. So I encourage you to pause this video and try to do this on your own before I try to work through it. So let me give a go at it. So instead of first starting at L of T, I'm going to actually start with L as a function of U, where U is another variable. I'll just use this kind of an intermediary variable that'll help set it up in a little bit of a simpler way, where U is days after June 21st. So let's just think about this a little bit. June 21st, if we're thinking about in terms of U, U is going to be equal to 0, because it's 0 days after June 21st. But if we're thinking about in terms of T, June 21st is the 172nd day of the year. It's 172. So what's the relationship between U and T? Well, it's shifted by 172 days. U is going to be equal to T minus 172. Notice, when t is 172, u is equal to 0. So let's figure out L of u first, and then later we can just substitute u with t minus 172. So first of all, what's happening when u is equal to 0? Let me write all this down. So what is happening when u is equal to 0? Well, u equals 0 is June 21st, and that's the maximum point. So what trig function hits its maximum point when the input into the trig function is 0? Well, sine of 0 is 0, while cosine of 0 is 1. Cosine hits its maximum point. So it seems a little bit easier to model this with a cosine. So it's going to be some amplitude times cosine of, and let's say I'll write some coefficient C right over here. Actually, let me just use a B since I already used an A. Some coefficient over here times RU plus some constant that'll shift the entire function up or down. So this is the form that our function of U is going to take. And now we just have to figure out what each of these parts are. So first, let's think about what the amplitude and what the midline is going to be. The midline is essentially how much we're shifting the function up. So let's get our calculator out. So the midline is going to be halfway between these two numbers. So we can say 1,096.5 plus 382.5 divided by 2 gets us to 739.5. So that's what C is equal to. C is equal to 739.5. Now the amplitude is how much do we vary from that midline. So we could take 1,096 minus this, or we could take this minus 382.5. So let's do that. So let's take 1,096.5. Minus what we just got, 739.5, and we get 357. So this is how much we vary from that midline. So A is equal to 357. So this right over here is equal to 357. So what's B going to be equal to? And for that, I always think about, well, what's the behavior of the function? What's the period of the function going to be? Let me make a little table here. So when u, let's put some different inputs from u. From u, when u is 0, we're 0 days after June 21st. We're at our maximum point. And we already said that what we want the cosine function to evaluate to at that point is essentially we want it to evaluate as 357 times cosine of 0 plus 739.5. Now, what happens? What's a full period? Well, a full period is a year. At a year, we get to the same point in the year, which is, I guess, a little bit of common sense. So you go all the way to 365. You go all the way to, when u is 365, we should have completed a period. We should be back to that maximum point. So this should essentially be 357 times cosine of 2 pi. When do we, if we were just thinking in terms of a traditional trig function, if we just had a theta in here, you complete a period every 2 pi. So this should be equivalent to what I'm writing out right over here, plus 739.5. So one way to think about it is b times 365 should be equal to 2 pi. Notice this is going to be b times 365. So let's write that down. B times 365 times 365, that's the input into the cosine function, needs to be equal to 2 pi. Or b is equal to 2 pi over 365. B is equal to 2 pi over 365. And we are almost done. We figured out what a, b, and c are. Now we just have to substitute u with t minus 172 to get our function of t. So let's just do that. So we deserve a little bit of a drum roll now. L of t is equal to a, which is 357 times cosine of b, 2 pi over 365, 2 pi over 365 times, not u, but now we're going to write it in terms of t. We want to think about day of the year, not days after June 21st. So times t minus 172, and then finally plus our midline, plus 739.5. And we are done. So it seems like a very complicated expression, but if you just break it down and kind of think about it, make the point that we're talking about, the extreme point, either the minimum or the maximum, make that when the input into our function is 0 or 2 pi, right? 0 is actually the easiest one. And then later you can worry about the shift. Hopefully you found that helpful.